टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विथ यूनिट नंबर 6, आईओटी फिजिकल सर्वर्स एंड क्लाउड ऑफरिंग्स. सो इन दिस यूनिट द टाइटल ऑफ द यूनिट सजेस्ट दैट वी आर गोइंग टू सी वेरियस क्लाउड रिलेटेड कॉन्सेप्ट्स दैट आर यूज्ड इन योर आईओटी. वी आर गोइंग टू सी सच थिंग्स इन दिस यूनिट. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ इंट्रोडक्शन टू क्लाउड स्टोरेज मॉडल्स एंड डिफरेंट कम्युनिकेशन APIs. So here we are going to see which different communication APIs can be used to communicate between the cloud and IoT application. So we are going to see various models and various communication APIs. You all are know what exactly the cloud computing is. Cloud computing is a transformative computing paradigm that involves delivering application and services over the internet. So the cloud computing mainly works over the internet, and it will going to provide various activities, like it will going to provide the infrastructure, software, platform through the internet. You can use those services with the help of internet only. Unless and until there is no internet, you cannot treat it as a cloud. It will be your what? Client and server architecture. So in case of cloud computing, you must require the internet, just like your IoT. In case of IoT, the internet is must. In the similar way, for cloud computing, the internet is again what is the important factor that will be focusing the various services. So in this unit, we will see how to use the cloud computing for IoT. To use the IoT application, we are going to see how the IoT applications and cloud computing can be worked together in this unit. We are going to see WAMP, that is the platform as a service. If you remember the one thing about your cloud computing, that is your PaaS, platform as a service. And here we are going to see WAMP as a PaaS. Also, we are going to see Amazon Web Services and their applications for IoT. We are going to see different AWS services that are used for your IoT applications. So this is the very first architecture that we are going to see is WAMP. WAMP stands for Web Application Messaging Protocol. So it is one type of protocol that is used for the messaging purpose over the internet in different web applications. That's why the name suggests that it is Web Application Messaging Protocol. With the help of this protocol, the message can be transferred from one application to another application over the website or over your what web applications through the internet. It is a sub protocol of your WebSocket, which provides number one publish subscribe model and number two remote procedure call messaging platform. We already gone through publish subscribe model. There is one publisher and there are different subscribers. Publisher will going to publish the message and the subscriber will going to receive the message at their end. So this is the sub protocol. WAMP is the sub protocol of this your what WebSocket, which will provide you the publish subscribe method. And second one is your remote procedure call, RPC. You all are aware about the RPC, remote procedure call. What happens in case of your RPC? There are two systems, system A and system B. The system B will have one procedure defined over the system B, and you need to access the that procedure through another system, that is your from A system. You are going to do this activity with the help of network. So A system will going to call the procedure develop on the system B with the help of network or with the help of some internet. This is called as your RPC or remote procedure call. If you divide this RPC into different word, you will come to know that remote means what? You are going to access it remotely. That means from one system to another system. And if you want to access it remotely, you will be requiring what? Internet or network. Then procedure. You all are aware about what is procedure, or we can say method, or it can be your function. And call means you are going to call that method, or you are going to call that procedure remotely. So this protocol is responsible for your RPC communication. Here you can see that there is one client and there is one router or there is one receiver. So here the role of a client, it will be treated as your publisher, or it will be treated as your what? Subscriber. It can be treated as your caller or callee. Likewise, here you can see that then there is one transport session. That transport protocol is responsible for establishing the communication between these two devices. And there is one router. The router will be treated as either your dealer or it will be treated as your what? Broker. Dealer or broker will going to provide the responses to your what? Client. Whatever client will going to send the request, that client will going to get the response from this router or from this broker or from this dealer. Now what exactly the transport is? Transport is the channel that will going to connect the two peers, the client and server. The connection between the client and server will be done with the help of this transport. Then what is session? The session is the conversation between two peers that runs over the transport and with the help of again one of the network. So session is the communication, or it will be the conversation between client and server, or client or broker, publisher or subscriber. What is client? Client is a peer that can have one or more roles. A client will have different roles, or it will have different what? Roles. What is publish and subscribe model will going to do in case of your WMP? The publisher will going to publish various events including your what? Payload. Payload can be treated as your what? The data transmitted from one device to another device. So what publisher will going to do? Publisher will going to publish various events. What events? For example, it will going to send the request, or it will going to send the response, or the message is broadcast. All this activity can be done by your what? Publisher. And that can be maintained by the broker. Whereas there is a second entity called as your subscriber. Subscriber subscribes to the topics and receives the event including the payload. Whatever events generated by the publisher, all those events are received by the subscriber at the subscriber end. So publisher will going to publish the event and subscriber will going to receive those events. And event can be either sending or receiving the data, or sending or receiving the message data packets. Whereas in case of your RPC model, client can be the caller or the client can be your callee. So what exactly the caller is? Caller is the person who is going to call, and callee is the person to whom the person is going to call. So caller issues the call to the remote procedure along with call argument. You can call along with some parameters. You can pass the parameter while calling someone. The example is, I can call any one of you in general, or I can call any one of you by the name. So when I call you by the name, then that will be your argument. And if I call someone, then it will be in general. That means I am addressing to the whole class. So when you are going to pass the argument, the specific person will going to focus. But when I call in general, everyone has to focus on the instruction. So that is what the argument in case of your caller is, and person to whom the caller is going to call. Callee executes the procedure to which the calls are issued by the caller and returns the result back to the caller. What is router? Routers are the peer that perform generic call and event routing. The router will going to route the events from which device to which device the event will going to occur. That will be done by your what? Router. So in short, router will going to specify the path, or router will going to define the path for data transmission. In publish subscribe model, the router has a role of broker. That means it act as a router. It will going to route the message from one device to another device. In case of RPC model, the work of router will be the broker, and it will going to work as a dealer. So what exactly the dealer is? Dealer again will be treated as your router in case of your RPC model.
In case of publish subscribe model, the router will be treated as broker, but in case of your RPC model, the router will be treated as your dealer. The dealer will act as a router. It will going to route the remote procedure call from caller to callee and route the result from callee to caller. So what exactly dealer will going to do? It will going to establish the route between caller and callee. The work of dealer is only to establish the connection between caller and callee, means two peers or two different entities.